couldn't have gone too far because I ended up having a seizure and the baby being removed out at 7 months because of pressure. But maybe if I had the medication in time, like if I could get all the medication, maybe I would have gone up to 9 months and have my baby in a normal way.
It's every pregnant mother's dream to give birth and see their baby grow. However, many do not live to see this in Uganda. Some either lose their babies or even lose lives to a condition that doctors call preeclampsia. Preeclampsia is a complication of pregnancy. Preeclampsia may cause high blood pressure, proteinuria, or other signs of organ damage. Dr. Emmanuel Vyaruhanga, the director of Kawempe National Referral Hospital, warns of the signs and symptoms of preeclampsia.
First of all, we have three grades. Preeclampsia without severe features. Usually you don't have symptoms until you go and they check and they find you have high blood pressure, you have some protein in urine. Now, the severe features come in, that's the where you need admission. And these include you can have headache, you can have blurring of vision, you can have pain in the upper outer quadrant, and you have swelling of the body, especially the legs. And then once you ignore this condition, then you start feeding. Quesca, which is generalized tonic-clonic quesca, not just quesca on one side. It's usually the whole body.
According to data, Kawempe gets more than 150 mothers with preeclampsia, and 10 of them get a severe one. Professor Annette Nakimli, chairperson of Preeclampsia National Committee, says many of the mothers that get into this condition get premature births, and this has led to high mortality rate because some of these babies do not survive.
Currently, we struggle with the magnitude of preeclampsia, but we know it's generally about 6% of pregnancies. That is 6 out of every 100 pregnant women. The important figure to know is that it causes 16% of all the women who die. Remembering that there are so many causes of death of women, but this one cause is responsible for 16%. But also, that's why it is number 2 cause of death are newborns. And we also need to emphasize newborns because you've heard one of my colleagues tell you that the ultimate cure of preeclampsia is to deliver the mother. Many times we deliver them prematurely. So the babies die because of prematurity.
Preeclampsia is a very big problem, not only in the country, but also here in Kawempe. It's the leading cause of maternal death in the last year. And also so far in this year. And on average, in a month, we have 150 mothers with this condition. Out of those 150, on average, 10 have what we call eclampsia, or the fits, the severe form of the PET. So nationally, it's number 2. Postpartum hemorrhage is number 1. This condition, PET eclampsia, is number 2.
The Permanent Secretary, Minister of Health, Dr. Diana Twine, called up men to drive the anti-preeclampsia campaign because they are the lead causers. Atwine warns Ugandans on how dangerous this condition is to both the mother and the unborn baby.
That is a disease that it can be treated, it can be managed in a hospital, we can prevent complications early, and we can actually look after the baby, and the baby can grow even in that condition. So, by doing that, we actually hitting two birds with one stone. The awareness is aimed at, first of all, improve ownership of the pregnancy and taking responsibility so that these mothers come early to antenatal and also getting treated. But also, we are preventing another bird we are hitting is that we are going to reduce maternal mortality due to eclampsia. Eclampsia now in Kawempe is the leading cause. Before it was the bleeding.
Recently, Ministry of Health launched the 10 days awareness campaign against preeclampsia. This is because the recent studies and healthcare reports reveal a concerning rise in the prevalence of preeclampsia, posing serious challenges to maternal well-being and necessitating urgent attention from healthcare authorities. It poses substantial risk to both maternal and fetal health, including preterm birth, low birth weight, and maternal mortality. As Uganda grapples with the rising prevalence of preeclampsia, urgent and coordinated efforts are required to protect the health of expectant mothers. The government, in collaboration with healthcare stakeholders, must prioritize maternal health initiatives, ensuring that every woman, regardless of location or socioeconomic status, has access to high-quality antenatal care and timely interventions to combat this growing health issue.
You must be checked at 6 hours, checked at 6 days, and checked also at 6 weeks, and those are the 3 postnatal care visits that we recommend. Otherwise, the blood pressure can actually increase when you're in this period that's called postpartum period, and it actually causes you the same features, the fitting, and you're going to eclampsia.
And eclampsia cannot be dealt with until the patient themselves know what to do. Come early, get treated early, because by the time they come here normally, they come when they have complications of their kidney, complications, their fitting, their organs have started failing. So we don't want to get there. We want to prevent this, and then we have better outcomes of their babies and the mothers.
According to the World Health Organization, preeclampsia is responsible for approximately 10-15% of maternal deaths worldwide. Compiled by John Masenze for New Vision.